My name is Mindy Feldman Hecht. I work at Columbia University Medical Center. I'm a research coordinator, and I primarily work on projects that are related to promoting health among children, related to healthy eating and physical activity, as well as preventing stroke and other chronic diseases. I'm Jewish, and I grew up with a very strong belief in social justice work and, you know, working on behalf of those most in need. So I went to visit different communities around the world. I spent a month in Uganda, a couple months in Thailand, communities where there are many different issues at play, and the issue of lack of access to health and healthcare was something that really spoke to me. And when I came back, that was something that I was trying to figure out, you know, how do I apply this to a career? My dad had the most profound effect. He was a doctor. Even though I didn't know the full details of his research career, I actually learned once I started working here at Columbia University that what I do as part of this team is very closely related to what my father did with his team in the 80s and 90s, which was he was focusing on teaching children in schools in northern Manhattan all about asthma, how to treat asthma, how to manage it, and also how to teach the children to go home and share what they learn with their parents, which is a model that I use every day, where I help to create school-based health education programs where we teach children all about eating healthy, exercising, preventing diseases like stroke, and then also teaching the children how to then go home and teach their parents what they've learned. The disease that I'm focused on is childhood obesity. It's a very significant disease in our time. It affects about 30% of kids between the ages of 2 and 19. So the numbers are just really staggering. What I really want to focus on is bringing those numbers down and bringing kids, all kids, back to a healthy weight and knowing what a healthy weight is, really creating a healthy generation together. Obesity is something that can be prevented through changing lifestyle, by eating healthy and exercising. It's something that there is a lot of research that can be done. What are the best ways to impact and prevent childhood obesity?
We can sit recess.
Exactly. So, she's a great candidate, and the kids are really excited about it. So I think it's going to be perfect.
Great.
Nowadays in schools, because of all the pressures of testing and all that, their physical activity, physical education is often the first class that's cut, and a lot of schools don't have access to even gyms or playgrounds. So the idea behind this program that I'm helping to develop is to allow for in-classroom short activity breaks. So, you know, let's say a math lesson is going on for 60 minutes, the teacher finds that her students are losing focus, so she can pause the lesson, plug in the video that I've helped to create, and for 10 minutes the kids will get up, you know, do some jumping jacks, move around and do some lunges, whatever it is for 10 minutes. And there's a lot of research that shows that kids who are active actually do better in school. So I'm part of a really great team at Columbia University. It's a very diverse team, so we're made up of public health researchers, doctors, clinicians, nurses, and even hip-hop artists.
Kids, come join me and let's do the show. Come on. Stroke. Put your hands up.
Just in the past year alone, we've had two cases of a kid who had been in the program, had learned all the signs and symptoms of stroke, had learned the correct action, which is calling 911, and they had been in a situation where a family member was actually having a stroke, and the child recognized that the family member was having a stroke and knew exactly what to do. In one case, the child was actually the individual to call 911, get the ambulance to their house, and get their family member the help that they needed, and they really, both those children, saved somebody's life, which is just, you know, incredible. I feel that medical research is incredibly impactful and can change so many people's lives, especially working in public health where we're focused on populations. You know, the impact that we can have is huge. You know, sometimes with doctors you're working one-on-one, but here we're really focused on an entire population and also preventing diseases from happening later in life, or, you know, if someone's had a disease, so rehabilitating them and bringing them back to health. And the scale of what you can do is just so enormous, and you can do so much good through research. I would say that at the end of the day, I feel fulfilled.